Hi children, today we are going to learn about my family. Okay, so in this my family we are having a big question, that is central idea, what makes a family. Okay, so when we take what makes a family, I have just brainstormed the entire topic. Okay, so what are the stuffs that we are going to deal with? So children, the very first point which we are going to see under my family is types of families. How these families are classified? Basically, it depends upon the number of members. Okay, so depending on the number of members, we are classifying the families into nuclear family, extended nuclear family, single parent family, joint family, okay, working parent family. Children, even though families are classified into different types, okay, family means a lot. When a group of people who loves, shares and cares for each other, only then it is considered as family. So next we are going to learn about change in family. So what is change in family? When something is being different from what it once was, either it may be big or small, or whether the change may make us happy or sad or angry. For example, big change. Sometimes when you buy a new car, it's a big change for your family. Children, when you make some changes within your house, that becomes a small change, children. So among the family, there are some changes which makes you happy, sad and angry. When you purchase a new car, it becomes a happy change. For example, if you have a puppy and if it is not feeling well and it has passed away, that becomes a sad change in your family. What makes your angry within the family? What kind of change makes you angry? When your parents suddenly, if they shift their house from one place to another, all of a sudden you will miss all your old friends in that old locality. So that makes you angry. So that kind of change, shifting of house from one place to another, makes you angry. Hope you're clear. Children, what is a family? A family is a group of people who are related to each other, such as mother, father and their children. Okay, we all know that families are classified into different types. Yes, based upon its number of members. Okay, now here we are going to see three different types of family through a beautiful story. Okay, it's a story about Roshan, Neha and Tanya. Yes, there are three characters. Okay, here in this story, Neha and Tanya, they both are dwelling in one area. Okay, so Roshan and his family, they shifted their house from another area to the area where Tanya and Neha are dwelling. So once they shifted, they started to unpack their things. Okay, as Roshan was helping in unpacking the things for his mother, suddenly Neha entered Roshan's house, introducing herself. Hi, I live next door. I'm Neha. In reply to Neha, Roshan also introduced himself. Hi, I'm Roshan. Nice to meet you. We have just moved in, which means they have just shifted their house over there. Immediately, Neha is asking Roshan whether he needs any help in unpacking. On hearing this, Roshan is replying to Neha, no need. Thanks for asking me. My older brother Rayon will be here to help me. On hearing this, Neha is again questioning Roshan about his family, whether he is having an older brother or he is having even sister too. Okay, so she is asking about Roshan's family. So immediately Roshan is replying, no, I don't have any sister. I have only mom, dad and my brother Rayon. Along with me, there are four members in our family. Okay, so can you guess what sort of family it is? Yes, children, it's a nuclear family. So look at here, Neha is asking Roshan that he must have been really tired because of the move. Okay, you would have done the packing works too, like how he is unpacking now. Similarly, he would have done the packing works too. So in reply to this, Roshan is answering to Neha that his mother will always allocate the duties between him and his elder brother Rayon. Older means elder. Okay, both are same. Yes. So Roshan is replying to Neha that Rayon and himself, they both will pack and unpack the books and toys. Okay, so that was the work allotted for them by their mother. On hearing this, Neha is questioning, is that why you are doing the unpacking? So Rayon will come and unpack the rest. So on hearing this, Roshan is replying to Neha that both of their parents, both mom and dad, they always make sure that they feel comfort with their tasks, and they also appreciate them whenever they help them. On hearing this, Neha is feeling happy and she is telling it's really nice. So Roshan is also telling to Neha that both Roshan and his brother Rayon, they both will always stay away from arguments and they always work together, it seems, in order to keep each other happy. So on hearing this, Neha felt so excited and she said that, Roshan, you're so lucky that you have so many members in your family to comfort each other. And she also said to Roshan that she'll come back in the evening to introduce her mother to him. And she also told that her mother is the best for her. And she also told Roshan that they can go for a walk around the neighborhood along with her pet dog Milo. On hearing this, Roshan is asking about Neha's dad. So Neha, in reply, she told that she is living only with her mom and her dad doesn't live with them. On hearing this, Roshan felt sorry and also he understood that the reason behind why Neha got excited and said that his family is a big family. Neha is trying to tell about her mother to Roshan that her mother is great and they both will do lot of tasks together with lot of fun, and she also appreciates her whenever she helps her mother. I hope you guess what type of family does Neha belongs to. Yes, she belongs to single parent family. So now Neha started to narrate about Tanya's family who lives around the corner. So she told that Tanya lives in a very big family with all her grandparents, uncle, aunt, cousins and parents. Children, hope you understand what kind of family does Tanya belong to. Yes, she belongs to a joint family. So children, over here, Neha and Roshan came to conclusion that family is all about loving, sharing and caring for each other. Okay, either it may be big or small or happy or sad. Yes, all we have to do is we have to love, share and care for each other. Children, now let us see the types of family one by one. First, we are going to see about nuclear family. Nuclear family is nothing but a family which consists of parents with one or two children, where both the parents or one might work. Okay, so they do help one another in completing the household chores and duties. Okay, so that is called nuclear family. Yes, so next we are going to talk about the extended nuclear family. Okay, what is this extended nuclear family? When you see grandparents living in nuclear family, those families are called extended nuclear families. Next, we are going to talk about joint family. Joint family is something which is known as a larger family, which is larger than a nuclear family. Okay, several families staying together is called joint family, which consists of grandparents, uncles, aunts and cousins. Okay, where you have lot of fun. Yes. Apart from this, there are some family without both the parents. Okay, there might be either father or mother. This is because one of the parent might have died, or there may be some reasons behind the separation of the parents. Such type of family where you can find either father or mother with a child is known as single parent family or one parent family. So here we are going to discuss the difference between working parents and the parents at home. Okay. When we talk about working parents, in some families both the parents are working and in some families either mother or father is working. Okay. So even though they are working, they try to manage both household works and also the works that they do outside the house. And also they lack in spending some quality time with children. Some working parents, they try to spend some valuable time with children, but some of them don't find time to spend with their children. On the other hand, parents at home, they always get more time to spend with their
children.
Children, family is not only all about loving, caring and sharing. Sometimes it is also our responsibility to accept some changes. Okay, what are some changes? There are some changes which may happen in the family. Children, first of all, what is change? The word change refers to anything being different from what it once was. Hope you are clear. So, the change in family makes us to adjust, makes us to modify ourselves, makes us to think in advance, and sometimes it makes us to innovate. And sometimes we need to adapt and to develop ourselves. Especially when you shift a house from one place to another, you adapt, adjust and you modify yourself. Not only that, when there is a change in your family just by adopting a pet, which makes you to adapt and adjust and also to develop a skill in understanding its movements. Change is not all about adapt, adjust and develop. It is also to modify and to innovate. Just like when you modify your haircut, that is when you modify your hairstyle, and when you innovate new dishes and taste among your family. Change of a school makes you to adapt to that particular situation, and also you may think in advance when there is a change in your family just by the arrival of your relatives. Hope you understood what makes a family and what are the classification of family and also the changes that happens within the family.